our last video, we learned about the modern periodic table. What are the defects of modern periodic table and what are its merits and demerits. Now you are having a clear idea about it. Now our next topic is the periodic properties. You know, as the name indicates, periodic and properties. Now you are having an idea of periodicity. What is periodicity? The repetition of properties after a regular interval. That is said to be periodicity of an element. So, when we arrange the elements in group as well as in the periods, so particularly what we are saying, the some elements, they are repeating their properties. They are having similar properties. That is their periodicity. Okay. So, what is periodic property? The repetition of the physical as well as chemical properties of the element after a regular interval. That is said to be periodicity. Now, on that basis, we divide the periodic properties into two types. The basis is two. You know, what I want to say that the periodic property जो रहती है उसको हम किस आधार पे differentiate करते हैं, उसको differentiate करने के दो आधार हैं. One, on the basis of energy. Some properties we are defining on the basis of energy. Okay, so on the basis of energy, and some periodic properties we are defining on the basis of the size. Energy, whenever I am talking about the energy, means energy of the elements. Whenever I am talking about the size, that is the size of an atom. Is it clear to you? So, on the basis of energy, we define the properties into ionization energy, electron affinity, or it is also said to be nowadays electron gain enthalpy, and electronegativity. These are the three properties of elements which depend on energy. The basis of their division is energy. While atomic size, ionic size, and atomic volume. These are the property which we define on the basis of its size of an atom, clear, of an element. Now, atomic size is also said to be atomic radius, as well as ionic size is also said to be ionic radius. So, we will start from atomic size, okay? So, what we conclude in a group, the atomic size or atomic radius goes on increasing. It increases while in a period the atomic size or atomic radius it goes on decreasing. So now if I ask you which elements in the whole periodic table are having the largest atomic size, largest atomic radius. So as we know that as we are moving from left to right, it goes on decreasing, badh raha hai, and as we kam ho raha hai, decreasing, and as we move from top to bottom, it goes on increasing, isn't it? So the first group elements means the alkali metals in the whole periodic table, we can conclude the alkali metals, they are having larger atomic radius. Alkali metals are having larger or greater atomic radius. Their atomic radius is more. And the halogens, because I said you, the noble gases are exception. So for us, the last group is the halogen, the group 17, the halogens. So the halogens, they are having the least atomic radius. Pure periodic table mein sabse jyada alkali metals jo group hai unke element ki atomic radius hoti hai. Agar hum periodic table ke groups ki, periodic table ke elements ki baat kare to, aur halogens group ke jo element hai unki atomic radius sabse kam hoti hai. Now if I ask you which element, so in alkali metal sabse large hai, humko pata hai. But alkali metal may be as we move from top to bottom, so atomic radius increases. So in that scenario, सबसे ज़्यादा किसकी होनी चाहिए? Francisium की. Okay, so the largest atomic radius is of the atom francisium. But in some books you found it is given cesium. Because being a radioactive element, sometimes francium is not taken into consideration. But you remember the atomic radius, the highest atomic radius is of francium, or you can say that of cesium. And the lowest atomic radius, sabse kam atomic radius kiski rahegi? That is of the fluorine. Or you can say that in some books you found it is helium also given, because being a very smaller in size. Is it clear to you that which element is having the higher atomic radius and which element is having the lower atomic radius and how we can define it? Now the atomic radius, it also depends on certain factors. What we saw, that is a general only, but sometime it depends on that particular electronic configuration. The screening effect is also there, the shielding effect is also there. Okay, so what are all that we will see afterwards. So what is atomic size? So atomic size of an atom is defined as the minimum distance between the nucleus of an atom to its valence shell. Whenever I am talking about the valence shell, what is the meaning of valence shell? That is the last shell. Clear? So if you suppose it is nucleus of an atom and it is the last shell, so this distance between nucleus of an atom to its valence shell, it is said to be atomic radius of that atom. Clear? Now, or it is also said to be atomic size or atomic radius. Get it my point? So atomic size, or we can also define as atomic radius. Now, on this basis, we define the atomic radius or atomic size, clear, into three types. One is the metallic radius. One is the covalent radius. And another one is the van der Waal radius. So whenever I am talking about the metals, the atomic size or atomic radius of the metals, so at that time the atomic radius becomes, or that atomic radius, it is defined as the metallic radius. In detail we will see afterwards. The covalent radius, generally the atomic radius of the non-metals, it is said to be the covalent radius. In case of non-metals, the atomic radius is said to be the covalent radius. Then van der Waal radius. Now, in some species, in some atoms, there exists a weak force of attraction, that is said to be van der Waal force of attraction. Like in cases of noble gases. In noble gases, the force of attraction is a van der Waal force of attraction. That is why the atomic radius which is present over there, it is said to be the van der Waal radius. So you got what is the metallic radius, what is covalent radius, what is van der Waal radius. The atomic radius we can differentiate it into these three types. Now the question arises, on what factors does the atomic radius depends? On what factor it depends? So factors affecting atomic radius. Okay. So factors which affect atomic radius. So the atomic radius, it is affected mainly by the two factors. One is the, you can say that, electronic configuration. Electronic configuration. And another one is the force of attraction. Force of attraction. As we know that between nucleus of an atom and its valence shell, right, there exists a force. That force is said to be the force of attraction. We all knew, inside the nucleus, protons and neutrons were present. Outside the nucleus, electrons are present. These protons and these electrons, दे हेल्ड टूगेदर, वो दोनों साथ में है, प्रोटॉन्स एंड इलेक्ट्रॉन्स वो दोनों साथ में है। वो दोनों साथ में क्यों है? किसी फोर्स ने उन्हें बाइंड करके रखा है। जिस फोर्स ने उन्हें बाइंड करके रखा है उस फोर्स को हमने क्या नाम दिया? उस फोर्स को हमने कहा है इलेक्ट्रोस्टेटिक फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन। दैट फोर्स इज सेड टू बी इलेक्ट्रोस्टेटिक फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन। सो यू ऑल गॉट व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रोस्टेटिक फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन। ओके, नाउ दैट इलेक्ट्रोस्टेटिक फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन दैट इज देयर बट अगेन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ्यूगरेशन। इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ्यूगरेशन द वर्ड इटसेल्फ मींस इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड कॉन्फ्यूगरेशन। हाउ द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड इन शेल्स एंड सब शेल्स। इन एटॉमिक स्ट्रक्चर वी ऑलरेडी लर्न अबाउट द SVDF फोर ब्लॉक्स, राइट? हाउ द KLM एंड शेल्स आर प्रेजेंट इन एन एटम, हाउ द सब शेल्स आर प्रेजेंट इनसाइड द शेल्स and how the electrons are accommodated in that particular shells. Getting my point? That is said to be electronic configuration. Now we will see how it affects. Okay, so let's see how it varies in a group. So if I take the example of the first group elements, and now all of you knew the first group elements are the elements of alkali metals, right? So these are the hydrogen, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium and francisium. If we are moving down from top to bottom, we know that atomic number goes on increasing. Again, the atomic number increased, right? But if we see its electronic configuration, so the hydrogen is having the configuration 1s1. What it indicates? The hydrogen atom is having one shell and it is having one electron in the s subshell, right? Similarly, lithium is having 2s1, means lithium is also having the one electron is in the s shell, but now the shell is second, it is having the second shell. Similarly, sodium is in 3s1, potassium 4s1, rubidium 5s, it is 6s, it is 7s. What it indicates? As we move from top to bottom, so what it indicates? As we are moving from top to bottom, the atomic number increased. But with the increase in atomic number, beta, the number of shells also goes on increasing. Number of shells, you know, in which the subshells are present and in subshell the electrons are there. Okay. Are you able to see cesium then francisium? Okay. So, here the in hydrogen the first shell is there, while in lithium second, sodium third, potassium fourth, rubidium fifth, cesium sixth, and in the francisium seventh shell is present, and they all are having the subshell s only, right? So number of shell increase, number of atomic number increase, but with the increase in atomic number of shells also increase. Do you know what does it mean? Number of shell increase means, suppose if I take the example of hydrogen, so I can make the structure of hydrogen like this. It is having only one shell. Now lithium is having two shell, right? Here two electron, here one electron. If I want to make sodium, so sodium is having the 3, 2, 8, 1. Similarly, if I want to make the potassium, so it is having 4, right? 2, 8, 8, 1. Clear? So, see, here the atomic number increase, number of electron increase, but with that increase, this number of shells also goes on increasing. Means, the valence shell also increase. Now, for hydrogen, the valence shell is the first shell only. But for the francisium or for the cesium, the valence shell is the 6th and 7th respectively. मेरी बात समझ में आ रही है क्या आपको? जैसे ही हम मूव कर रहे हैं नीचे से ऊपर, सॉरी ऊपर से नीचे, क्लियर? तो नंबर ऑफ शेल क्या हो रही है? नंबर ऑफ शेल बढ़ रही है. एटॉमिक नंबर तो बढ़ रहा है, नंबर ऑफ शेल बढ़, लेकिन उसके साथ साथ नंबर ऑफ शेल भी बढ़ रही है. पीरियड में क्या हो रहा था? इलेक्ट्रॉन उसी शेल में एंटर कर रहा था, लेकिन ग्रुप में नंबर ऑफ शेल बढ़ रहा है. as the number of shell goes on increasing, so obviously now the distance is this much. But as we are moving, the distance goes on increasing, isn't it? Is it so? ऐसा होगा क्या? जैसे ही हम ऊपर से नीचे आएंगे तो डिस्टेंस बढ़ते जाएगा, ऑब्वियसली बढ़ेगा, ये नंबर ऑफ शेल बढ़ रही है. सो न्यूक्लियस के और वैलेंस शेल के बीच की दूरी क्या हो रही है? बढ़ रही है. ऑल्दो नाउ यू आर हैविंग वन क्वेश्चन, देन फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन आल्सो इंक्रीज ना. सो ऑफ कोर्स फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन आल्सो गोज ऑन इंक्रीज बेटा, बट दैट इंक्रीज इज नॉट दैट मच. फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन बढ़ रहा है लेकिन वो जो बढ़ रहा है, वो जो इंक्रीज है वो उतना नहीं है कि उस वैलेंस शेल को न्यूक्लियस अपनी तरफ खींच सके. बिकॉज नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इंक्रीज बाय ओनली वन. सी दे ऑल आर हैविंग ओनली वन इलेक्ट्रॉन इन द वैलेंस शेल, बट द शेल इंक्रीज बाय वन. लाइक इट इज हैविंग के शेल, इट इज हैविंग एल शेल, इट इज एम, देन एन, लाइक दैट इट गोज ऑन इंक्रीजिंग. सो व्हाट वी कंक्लूड, as we move from top to bottom, with the increase in atomic number, number of shells goes on increase, but there is not that much increase in the force of attraction. The force of attraction is not increase in that ratio. Clear? So the nucleus, now the distance between the nucleus and the valence shell becomes larger, becomes greater. So as we move from top to bottom, the atomic radius goes on increasing. What we conclude, as we move from top to bottom, atomic radius goes on increasing. So what we conclude beta, we conclude as we move from left to right, the atomic radius decreases, while as we move from top to bottom, the atomic radius goes on decreasing. Is it clear to you? So as we are moving from left to right, now we know that we are having periods and groups, so we have to see how the atomic radius varies in a period, how atomic radius it varies in a group. We know that these horizontal rows, they are said to be periods, and the vertical columns, they are said to be groups. If I take example of a particular period element, okay, for example, if I take lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine and neon, okay, so if I see the atomic number, so it is having the atomic number 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. If I saw the electronic configuration, so lithium is having the configuration 2-1, beryllium is having 2-2, boron is having 2-3, carbon is having 2-4, nitrogen is having 2-5, oxygen 2-6, fluorine 2-7, and it is 2-8. Okay. If I draw the structure of its nucleus and shell, so as we know that lithium is having two shells, right? So 2 and 1, it is a configuration, right? Here it is 2 and 2. Similarly, if I draw the structure, if I draw the last one, so that neon, it is having 2 and 8 electrons, right? In that outermost shell, in that valence shell. Is it clear to you? So what we have to remember over here is we are moving from left to right. Right? As we are moving from left to right, number of electrons increases, number of electrons goes on increasing. They are increased. See, here 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and in the last, that is a 10 electrons. And they are entering in the same shell, means the first shell is K, second is L. Right? So in L shell, the electrons are entering in the same shell. The atomic number is increased. Number of electrons also goes on increase. But the electrons enter into the second shell only. See, here 2-1 KNL shell, here KNL, here KNL, KNL, KNL means the last electron enter in the L shell. आपको मेरी बात समझ में आ रही है? जैसे ही हम लेफ्ट से राइट जा रहे हैं, नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन बढ़ रहे हैं, लेकिन नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन बढ़ तो रहे हैं, लेकिन वो उसी शेल में जा रहे हैं, है ना। अगर हम कॉन्फ़िगरेशन देखेंगे, डिफरेंस सिर्फ क्या है कि लिथियम के पास एक इलेक्ट्रॉन है एल शेल में, जबकि नियॉन के पास एल शेल में 8 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स है। यू आर गेटिंग माई पॉइंट? इज इट क्लियर टू यू? इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू रिमेम्बर। ये सबसे खास बात है यहाँ पर याद रखने की। सो यू ड्रॉ द फिगर लाइक दैट सो यू कम टू नो। क्लियर? इट इज हैविंग सपोज एट 2-3 एंड 2-4, 2-5, 2-6, 2-7 एंड लास्ट 2-8। सो द नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, सी दिस नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स दे गोज ऑन, द नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन दे गोज ऑन इंक्रीजिंग। एंड वेन इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इंक्रीज ऑटोमेटिकली प्रोटॉन्स ऑल्सो इंक्रीज। अगर इलेक्ट्रॉन का नंबर बढ़ रहा है तो प्रोटॉन का नंबर भी बढ़ रहा है बेटा। इलेक्ट्रॉन बढ़ रहा है, प्रोटॉन बढ़ रहा है, मतलब फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन भी क्या हो रहा है? फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन भी इंक्रीज हो रहा है। एज द नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन इंक्रीज, सो वॉट विल इंक्रीज ओवर देयर? वॉट यू हैव टू रिमेम्बर, देन फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन इट ऑल्सो गोज ऑन इंक्रीज। नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन बढ़ा, फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन बढ़ा। क्लियर? इसको हम कैसे समझेंगे कि यहाँ पे जो न्यूक्लियस है राइट, वो जो फोर्स लगा रहा है वो फोर्स है वो एक इलेक्ट्रॉन के कारण है राइट, और यहाँ पे कितने के कारण हो गया? 8 इलेक्ट्रॉन। सो नंबर इंक्रीज एज वी मूव फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट। सो एज द फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन गोज ऑन इंक्रीजिंग, जैसे अट्रैक्शन बढ़ता है, अट्रैक्शन बढ़ा, अगर आपका किसी से अट्रैक्शन ज्यादा है तो हम क्या करते हैं? सामने वाले को अपनी तरफ खींचने की कोशिश करते हैं। तो एज द नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन इंक्रीज द फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन इंक्रीज। सो वॉट न्यूक्लियस ट्राइज टू डू? द न्यूक्लियस ट्राइज टू पुल द वैलेंस शेल टूवर्ड्स इटसेल्फ। न्यूक्लियस क्या कोशिश करता है कि वैलेंस शेल को मैं थोड़ा और अपनी तरफ खींचू, और इस कोशिश में जब न्यूक्लियस ये कोशिश करता है कि मैं वैलेंस शेल को अपने और थोड़ा पास लाऊं, तो दूरी थोड़ी सी क्या हो जाती है बेटा? कम हो जाती है। सो व्हाट वी हैव टू रिमेम्बर, एज द नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन इंक्रीज फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन ऑल्सो इंक्रीज, बट द डिस्टेंस डिक्रीजेस। उसके कारण क्या होता है? द डिस्टेंस गोज ऑन डिक्रीजिंग। एंड वेन एवर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द डिस्टेंस मीन्स द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन न्यूक्लियस ऑफ एन एटम टू वैलेंस शेल। एंड व्हाट वी डिफाइन दिस डिस्टेंस, इस डिस्टेंस को हमने क्या डिफाइन किया? इस डिस्टेंस को ही हमने एटॉमिक रेडियस और एटॉमिक साइज डिफाइन किया है। सो व्हाट वी कंक्लूड नाउ, वी कंक्लूड एज वी आर मूविंग फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट विद द इंक्रीज इन नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स द फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन इंक्रीज, द न्यूक्लियस ट्राइज टू पुल द वैलेंस शेल टूवर्ड्स इटसेल्फ, एंड द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन न्यूक्लियस ऑफ एन एटम एंड वैलेंस शेल गोज ऑन डिक्रीजिंग। दस द एटॉमिक साइज गेट्स डिक्रीज और रिड्यूस। सो एज वी मूव फ्रॉम लिथियम टू फ्लोरीन, why I not said the word neon? Neon is the last one, but remember the noble gases are exception in this. Why they are exception, that I will tell you. Okay, so as we are moving from lithium to fluorine with the increase in atomic number of electrons and force of attraction, the atomic size or atomic radius goes on decreasing. So in a particular period, this first element, it is having the larger atomic radius, while this halogen, the last group, it is having the smaller radius. Now you know why noble gases are exception. As the noble gases, they are the non-metals, but noble gases, they possess van der Waal force of attraction. Which force of attraction they are having? The van der Waal force of attraction. And as the van der Waal force of attraction is a weak force of attraction, that is why generally noble gases are having slightly larger atomic radius as compared to halogens, because halogens are having the covalent radius. In the beginning I already told you there are three types of radius: metallic, covalent and van der Waal. So now you know how we can define the atomic size in a period. Now let's see what about the group.